everyone, my name is Emily, and today I am sharing a very festive project with you. We will be making these graphic placemats. I love to use them for any celebration we have in our house, whether it's a birthday, a Christmas, Valentine's Day, or not even a holiday, but like a retirement or even National Donut Day. I think it's so fun to have a little personalized bit of celebration that is waiting at your table or maybe for breakfast that just makes things a little bit more fun and festive. So I want to show you today the technique on how to make the placemats. You can make the placemats say whatever you'd like, but the key to getting the wording cut out just perfectly is our Olfa art knife. It gives you precise cutting, and it's like a fussy cutting, if you will. If you're a quilter and know that term, it's kind of like a fussy cutting, but it is so fun and so beautiful. So let's get started with cutting our shapes and our sizes, and then we'll work on the lettering together. So you will need a couple pieces of fabric for your background and your foreground. You will also need a piece of fabric for your lettering, and then you'll need a separate piece of fabric for your edging, just like it is here. So background, foreground, your lettering, and your edging. And they can match, they cannot match, you can use up scraps, whatever you'd like. But the big piece is cut 11 by 17. Your edges will be 2-inch strips, and then you'll need to cut this lettering area another 11 by 17, because I'll show you in the technique that we use, you'll want the whole area to be taken up with this space with your lettering, so that when we cut it out, we can use the background as kind of our spacing or our like setting on how we set the letters. So background will be cut to 11 by 17. So I'm gonna cut that first. If you need to give your fabric a quick iron, always feel free to do that. So my two background pieces are cut 11 by 17, and then I will need to cut the same top piece or lettering piece out of the same size. So now that this piece is cut, I'm going to set this aside and cut my 2-inch strips. And just make sure that you cut enough yardage so that the 2 inches can go on the 17-inch side, the 17-inch side for front and back, so 4 17-inch or 18-inch strips, along with enough along the 11-inch side as well. So it'll essentially be 8 strips, 4 for the front, 4 for the back, 2 of them being longer for the top and 2 being shorter for the sides. So I have my 4 strips for the front and 4 strips for the back all ready to go from what I had just cut, and now I'm going to iron on my interfacing. Every interfacing is a little bit different, but your interfacing is just basically thin glue that kind of gets activated from the heat of your iron, and it looks like this. It's this webbing sort of material that looks like it's on the back of parchment paper, and I am simply going to iron my interfacing onto the back side of this sort of aqua green color. Now mine, I'm using solid, so I don't really have a right and wrong side. So you can choose whatever your right and wrong side is. But I've pre-cut my piece to be this 11 by 17 piece. And all I'm gonna do is line up my interfacing piece, and I'm gonna start pressing. Now, there's a difference between pressing and ironing. And ironing is when you move your iron around and you're ironing a shirt. Pressing is when you leave the iron set on top of the whatever you're ironing. So it's using kind of the weight of the iron to press your interfacing in place. The reason why you wanna press interfacing versus iron it is ironing is with this motion, and you wanna make sure that you're not stretching out the interfacing underneath. It's not the end of the world if you do, but once you get everything glued in place and you'll kind of see that the paper starts sticking, to the fabric. You can start to kind of see that over here in this area that I've already ironed. Then you can iron back and forth. But really work on pressing your interfacing in place across your whole 11 by 17 piece of fabric. Okay, I think everything is about set in place. Sometimes I like to just go over the edges a little bit more just to make sure everything is, and you'll be able to see this is kind of all one big piece. It's nice and glued together, if you will. So I'm gonna set my pressing mat and my iron aside and get out my cutting mat because this is where the fun really is. So like I said before, you want your entire lettering. I think it looks best if your entire lettering takes up the entire kind of surface or foreground of your placemat, less the edging. So I've decided to make a happy birthday placemat today. And all I did was write out the words happy birthday and turn them kind of into an outline on my computer. And then I printed them on two pieces of 8.5 by 11 piece of paper, which happens to fill up the entire 11 by 17 area. So all we're gonna do is cut out these letters by placing my paper right on top of my fabric that I had just ironed my interfacing to. And this is gonna become the glueable letters that will become our graphic placemat lettering or wording. Now, of course, you can translate this very same technique into a little graphic, like a little bird or a tree or a flower or something really simple. If you have your printed shapes on a piece of paper, it's easy to use your art knife and cut them out precisely so that it becomes kind of like a template, if you will. I'm going to be using the Olfa art knife, which is one of my favorite tools in my craft room. The blade that I will be using is the curved carving blade. Now, this curved carving blade is absolutely perfect for precise cuts like this because it's curved, and I'm gonna show you how I'm able to rock the blade into the edges so that we don't have overcutting on the placemat letters. So the first thing I'm going to do is you can use pins, you can use anything to kind of keep this in place. I love these little pin weights because I feel like it's just an easy thing to keep right on top here and it keeps everything nice and in place. The first cut I'm going to make is by placing the tip of my art knife onto my letter and then kind of rocking down so that I'm inserting and slicing between the fabric and the paper. Now when I get to an edge, just like the edge here of the happy birthday, I'll slowly begin to lift up until the point reaches the very point of the H. The reason this art knife is amazing is not only because it's honed in, just like all of the other Olfa rotary blades that we already know and love, it's because it is so precise by using this rocking technique, and it's so sharp, and this blade does not even move a tiny instance. So I will just continue cutting out all of these letters in my happy birthday wording. You can already see the letter lifting up. When I get to an edge, I can kind of slow down and just work my knife around that corner edge and press as I'm coming down these long edges. Look at this. This is our first letter coming out right here. So what I want to make sure I do is set aside each letter and then keep this in place because we will be using this background excess fabric, or excuse me, background excess paper as like our template on how we're gonna lay the letters back out. One other thing to point out is when you have a inside of like the A, for instance, this triangle inside, I would highly recommend to cut the inside out first because if you cut away the outside of the letter or this kind of outer rim of the letter first and try and cut the inside out second, the cut is actually probably going to be so good that your letter is gonna wiggle around and move around because it will already be free from the bigger paper. So I recommend cutting this inside out first. Okay. Okay, so now that all of my letters are cut out, I've saved them up here and I have my background all ready to go. So now I'm going to press my letters onto the foreground of the front of my placemat. So I'm gonna grab my iron and pressing mat to do that, and we'll move this stuff off to the side and save this piece, the paper piece. Remember, this can just be a really cool maybe background that you maybe iron onto something else. So maybe don't throw that away if you don't want to. But I now have my iron and pressing mat, and now I'm simply going to take the foreground of the front of my placemat, lay out my sort of template, which is going to give the spacing exactly how I want it to be, and now I'm going to start to lay out my letters. Before I lay every letter, I'm going to take my pincher fingers and kind of rub a little bit. If you kind of start to wiggle or rub, it separates the parchment from the fabric itself. And you'll see that on the back side of the fabric, there's like a little bit of a shininess, and that's the glue or the interfacing. So essentially you just want to peel off the paper backing, set that aside, and you're left with a piece of fabric perfectly cut, which has the letter in it. So I'll just continue to do that, wiggle my fingers back and forth and keep taking out my various letters. That goes here, and fill in all of my spaces. Okay, so I have my last letter that I'm going to place on. If it's ever sticky like this, simply lick your finger and it should, there we go, give you some grip to be able to pull that backing off. But now that I have my last letter, you can kind of fidget it around and make sure everything is in place. The one thing you will want to do is kind of lift up a little bit on your paper template to make sure that the letters are underneath the template itself, because when we give it a quick press, you want to make sure that the letters don't get fused to the paper, but rather they get fused to the fabric. So just kind of work your fingers around and make sure that your paper is over top of your letters instead of under it. And you can kind of peel it away as you go. There we go. So I have everything just perfectly spaced, just like I did in my paper template. And now I'm just going to be a little bit fussy and move that a little bit down. But now all I'm going to do is press, just like we did before, not iron, but press your letters into place. And it's so much more important in this case to press, because if we iron, we're going to be moving these letters all around. So again, if you need to reference the specific instructions on the actual brand of the interfacing that you purchased, go ahead and do that. But a good press and you'll start to see these letters actually fuse to this background of the placemat. So now that all my letters are pressed into place, I'm going to applique my letters on, which will just give it more sturdiness or washable ability. We call it washability in my house, because with little kids, everything needs to have a high washability. And I'm just gonna stitch. You can choose any applique stitch you want. It can be a straight stitch, which is what I will be doing. It can be a zigzag stitch. It can be a fancy stitch, but you don't even have to do this step if this feels pretty tricky, but I would recommend it, because then these letters will stick on really, really well. So I'm going to grab my sewing machine and get started appliquing. So I'm going to choose to just do a straight stitch right around the outside of the letters, just to adhere the letters to the placemat. And I'm choosing to use, I think sometimes the thread color is the funnest, I'm choosing to use kind of a hot pink thread color, because I really want to make sure that these letters stand out and that there is as much color as possible on these celebration placemats. So I'm just going to straight stitch all the way around. And then of course, as I come to these curved edges, I'll just slow down. I find that sometimes on curved edges, it can be a little bit tricky to get all the way around the edge in the bulk of the fabric. So I usually lift up my foot, and then you can make it around a little bit easier so that you're not kind of forcing it as much. And you'll kind of feel that underneath the foot of your machine along with your needle. And then as always, when you come to a sharp corner, leave your needle down, lift your foot, and just pivot your fabric. So when I get to the end of my letter, a lot of times when you're appliquing, you have the choice to kind of do the backwards forward stitch or to anchor your stitch. I choose to anchor the stitch because I really like the kind of the seamless look of the one stitch around the edge, and I don't want that bulk of the backwards forwards. So I am just going to trim off my thread, and look at, I think it turned out so cute because you can see kind of the outline. It makes it more kind of drawn and designerly. And I'm just going to continue working around each letter, applicating it in a straight stitch for the whole happy birthday words. Okay, so I just finished appliquing all of my letters onto my foreground of my placemat pattern. So now I'm going to add my 2-inch stripping along the edge. So remember we had cut, or I had cut 4 of these really long pieces of 2-inch strips. I'm just gonna cut them in half because that's just how my fabric was laying. Now I'm left with 2 2-inch strips that are going to go along the long edges of both the foreground or the front of the placemat and the back of the placemat. So sew these 2-inch strips along the front of the long side, which would be the top and the bottom, and then the long side, which would be the top and the bottom of the back, and you'll be sewing them right sides together. You'll notice that likely your fabric, or you'll want your fabric to kind of go off of the edge here so that you have an extra 2 inches. And we want that because then we're able to add our 2-inch strip onto the short sides. So I'm using probably a 1/4-inch seam allowance like I always do, and just sew these right sides together along these 4 long sides on the front and the back of the placemat. Then I'm repeating this on the long side of the back side of my placemat, right sides together with 1/4 inch of a seam allowance. My long sides are sewn, and before I sew my short sides on, I want to both press my seam allowance to the left side or the right side, or press them open, whichever you prefer, and then I want to trim the edges. So I'm going to move my sewing machine out of the way, and I will go to my pressing mat next. So I am going to simply press my seams open or to the side. I know there's a big debate about whether seams get pressed open or to the side. I'm choosing just to press my seams to the side so that my edge or my edging is nice and flat. And I will do this along both of these long edges. Sometimes I like to tug my seams open just a little bit to make sure all the fabric is nice and open. But if you flip it over, you'll kind of start to see the beginnings of our finished product, which I love. And then I'll repeat the same for the front. You can see I didn't clip any of my strings on the back, which is totally fine. It doesn't bother me because I know that this is gonna be the inside of the placemat. If it bothers you, go ahead and trim all those threads if you want to. So this is nice and flat, but I still have to trim off these edges here because I want this to be nice and flush. So I'm just going to move my pressing mat off to the side and bring in my cutting board. And I am going to layer both my front and my back together. And I'm going to line up these edges, just like this, that this edge is one nice long line. And then all I'm going to do is simply trim off this excess here. There's a ton of different ways that you can add edging to placemats or pillows or napkins. And some people like a beveled edge, some people do a flush edge just like this. So if you have a different technique of how you want to add on your edging, please feel free to do that. I feel like this is just very easy no matter what kind of patterned fabric you have. So it's kind of a tried and true method for me. All right. So long sides are trimmed up. So we have our nice long edge on our front, on the top and the bottom for both the front and the back. And now I'm gonna go back to my sewing machine to add on this short strip in the same way, right sides together with a quarter of an inch seam. So I'll begin to sew my short edges of the front side of the placemat and the back side of the placemat, both on the left and right sides, with my same quarter inch seam allowance. Okay, so now that all four short edges are sewn, we're gonna go back to our pressing mat, just like we did before, to press our edges flat and then trim off the excess before we put the whole placemat together. So I will just press my seams. I, again, chose to press my seams outward towards the edge. And to me, that works really well because these edges of the edges kind of tend to lay really flat when you press them outward. So that's how I chose. But again, like I said before, if you wanted to choose to iron them open, you absolutely can. So do the same for the back side of the placemat and the front side. And then we'll move our pressing mat out of the way again and go back to our cutting mat, just like we did the first time, to trim off these excess sections. So just like before, I'm gonna line up my long edges here along the outside of the long edges and just kind of do the best I can. And this just kind of helps, I think, keep everything nice and square or square-ish if possible. And then I can line up my Olfa straight edge, use my rotary blade, and just trim everything up really nicely. So now the very last step to our placemat is to put right sides together. So you're putting your lettering and your backside right sides together. And if you want a pin in place, you absolutely can put a few pins in here to get everything nice and straight with each other. Although I do feel like the way that we've cut our edges, it kind of is a little bit of a fail-proof way to make sure everything is nice and square. And I'm going to stitch a quarter inch or a little bit less of a stitch all the way around the outside four edges of the placemat. The only thing I want to make sure of is I'm going to leave an opening that is about, I don't know, 3 or 4 inches along the short side so I can flip my placemat right side out before we top stitch. So let's go back to our sewing machine one last time, or almost last time, to stitch the placemat closed, and then we'll just have to give it a quick iron and stitch one more time before we are finished with our celebratory placemat. So remember, when you're stitching this outside edge, to leave about a 2 or 3 inch opening on that short side so that we can flip our placemat right side out before you stitch all the way around. And remember, when you get to the edge, come right up to the edge, leave your needle down, lift your presser foot, and pivot your fabric to keep everything nice and flat. So I'll flip this right side out. This is the fun part. Poke out these corners as best as you can. Sometimes I like to wiggle them between my fingers. And then the one thing we need to do before we finish up and stitch everything closed is just to press the top really well. And the reason that we do this is because it gives, you're able to kind of wiggle out these seams along the edge and it'll flatten everything out nice and square. And one technique I like to use is to kind of use my pincher fingers and wiggle back and forth kind of along the edge just to make sure, just to make sure that your edge is nice and flat and nice and kind of square or right to the outside. When you get to the opening that you had left here, what I like to do is kind of notice my seam allowance along this edge right here. And I'll just kind of take my fingers and tuck it in so that it makes a nice edge, kind of pretending that it's sewn underneath, even though we know that it's not. This is a little bit bulgy, I should say, so I'm gonna tuck that in. There we go, once more. And then you can't even tell that it's an open seam. Okay, so I have one more finishing touch before our placemat is completed, and that is to do a top stitch. I'm going to move my pressing mat off to the side, bring my sewing machine back in, and I am just going to do a really simple top stitch along the outer edge. And a top stitch is like usually about an eighth of an inch-ish along the outside edge. It's kind of to finish it. I'm using the same bright pink thread so that it kind of ties everything together. And the function of it is to make sure that we close up that opening that we just left open to turn our placemat right side out. So this will not only give it a finished look, it'll actually finish the placemat, and then we are ready to celebrate and use our placemats, which I'm so excited about. So I'm just going to trim my threads. It's all stuck back here. There we go. Trim my thread. Push my sewing machine off to the side. And there we have it, our happy birthday graphic placemat that I think turned out so well. We have our hip hip hooray. So we have every celebration ready to celebrate with my family. And thanks to this awesome Olfa art knife, this project, this graphic placemat project, was the ultimate and easy fussy cutting technique that I think has me hooked to make more.